everyone, welcome back to our channel. I'm Dr. Amel from City Skin Clinic. Today I thought it would be great if we talk about one of my absolute favourite skin care ingredients, and it's hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is having a massive heyday, to be honest. It's been having quite a heyday for a while, but right now I think as more of us are indoors because of the pandemic and more people are interested in skincare, I've noticed there's a lot more advertising from kind of mainstream skin companies and really kind of promoting products that contain hyaluronic acid. Of course, this is one of our usual kind of videos where I'm going to tell you the awesome things about hyaluronic acid, but I'm also going to fact check a little bit. It is awesome, but some of the claims are not quite, you know, they're not quite there, let's just put it that way. It can be awesome without having to exaggerate it. So I will take you through what hyaluronic acid is, and what it does for our skin, and why it's great to incorporate it into your skincare routine, but also what are its limitations. Before I move on to this, if you're new to our channel, welcome. Please subscribe to our channel if you like this content and you want to kind of follow us and join our little community. If you are an existing subscriber, welcome back. Hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is actually a naturally occurring compound. It's found in our bodies, our cells make it up. It forms the kind of scaffolding of our tissues, and really like collagen, like elastin, these are other things that you might have heard of. Hyaluronic acid has a role to play. It's technically a sugar. And what it does is it our cells make it, and it gets put in the basement membrane. So this is, if you think of it, like the scaffolding that our cells kind of cling on to in order to make our organs and tissues and all of us. And we notice hyaluronic acid's functions in things like our joints, where it helps keep our joints lubricated so that we can move without being in pain, and also things like our skin. So in our skin, hyaluronic acid helps keep our skin hydrated. It helps support our skin's barrier so that it keeps away the elements, and it just keeps our skin nicely hydrated and moist. So what is hyaluronic acid? Like I mentioned, it's a sugar, and what it does is it's great at kind of holding onto water. So hyaluronic acid can hold onto 1,000 times its weight in water. And what that means is it kind of grabs onto water, and it acts as this reservoir of water for our cells. So our cells can keep hydrated, but not kind of expand and swell and overdo it. It also helps maintain a layer of hydration, to our skin. So hyaluronic acid, when applied to our skin, can help maintain a layer of hydration, and that can help support. So if you have dry skin, or if you have a thin skin barrier where you've lost, you lose a lot of moisture, then hyaluronic acid will help kind of support that. What your own cells haven't been able to do, that hyaluronic acid, when applied to the skin, will do that. The other thing that hyaluronic acid will do, because it's so good at hydrating the skin and skin cells, so when it's applied as a cream or a gel, whatever, a moisturizer onto the skin, it will also, cause the cells to kind of, if you think of it, if your skin is dry and dehydrated, you start to notice texture a lot more, you start to notice lines and wrinkles a lot more. When it's when the cells are hydrated, they're kind of plump, and they're a little bit sort of heftier, they're a little bit juicier, and so your skin will just look smoother, it'll look bouncier, and the appearance of lines and wrinkles will be less pronounced. So if you kind of think of a little dehydrated raisin versus a grape. You know, a grape is kind of juicy because it's full of water and its structure's all there, and a raisin is kind of, you know, really dry and wrinkly. And so hyaluronic acid, when applied to the skin, can help improve that. It's not going to make a raisin become a grape if you apply it onto that raisin, but it'll improve the kind of the appearance of the skin and make it look much much nicer, much smoother, a lot fresher looking. People who use hyaluronic acid also often get excited about the fact that their skin looks like it's glowing a lot more, it's more radiant. So it really is a beautiful, beautiful product. The best thing about hyaluronic acid is it's actually almost universally suitable. So it's not irritating. In fact, it's the opposite. It's, you know, all that hydration helps soothe irritated skin. So usually even people who might have sensitive skin may not have problems with hyaluronic acid. Of course, you should always, whenever you're trying out a new skin product, do a patch test to just make sure that your skin is fine with it. But we know that with hyaluronic acid, it's unlikely for people to have problems. The other thing is, even though it has acid in the name, it's not like exfoliating acids. You know, if we think of glycolic acid or lactic acid or any of those things, no, it doesn't. It's not an exfoliant. So what it does is just hydrates the skin, and so it's actually great if you are someone who has peels, or who uses kind of acid exfoliants, or if you're someone on retinol or tretinoin, then those things can dry out the skin, can make it flaky, and hyaluronic acid can help bring back that hydration. So this is the amazing thing with hyaluronic acid. It can be used day or night, multiple times a day. So I quite like using hyaluronic acid either in a serum or in a cream, or so a moisturizer, or both together. It works really nicely with that. There are also some exciting studies that are coming out that show that potentially hyaluronic acid, when applied to the skin, can also be an antioxidant. So in the same way that vitamin C, we've spoken about that before, is an antioxidant, hyaluronic acid may have the same effect. So it may help kind of stop damage from free radical damage from the environment. So it's not a substitute for sunscreen, but it will, it may help kind of with your skin. Hyaluronic acid is great because it can also be mixed with a number of different and used with a number of different skin care products. So it can be a serum that you apply to your face, you can mix it in with your moisturizer, you can use it alongside things like vitamin C serum without a problem. If you're using an exfoliating acid, you can use your you can use your hyaluronic acid after that. And then again in the evening, if you're someone who's using tretinoin and retinol, you can use hyaluronic acid after that. The one thing to bear in mind with hyaluronic acid, remember how I said it grabs onto water? So if you imagine when you apply it onto the skin, it's going to grab onto water, and we want it to have that water so that the cells can then start to take some of that water. What we don't want it to do is grab water from the cells. So when you apply hyaluronic acid, make sure that you apply it to wet skin, slightly damp skin, so that then the hyaluronic acid will grab onto that water and then keep it there for your cells to kind of make use of it. If you apply it to dry skin, then it may have the opposite effect. Other things that I really like about hyaluronic acid is actually really fine lines and wrinkles, especially in areas like around the eye, where the skin is also really thin. Using kind of a hyaluronic acid eye cream or eye gel can really make these wrinkles look better. So these are kind of the awesome things about hyaluronic acid, and it honestly, if you've not tried it before, it's worth giving it a go. There are so many awesome brands out there that provide hyaluronic acid products at multiple kind of price points. So you know, The Ordinary is a great place if you can access. It's a great brand to try out new skincare products and see if you like them, what your skin agrees with them. The thing that I will say is now, with everything that's awesome about hyaluronic acid, there are some exaggerations that people do, and some of these are just misinformation or confusion, and others are a little bit misleading. So I think sometimes people don't differentiate the difference between hyaluronic acid that you just put on your skin, like as a cream or a serum, versus hyaluronic acid that you inject into the skin, such as Profilo or dermal fillers. So the hyaluronic acid that you put onto the skin is great, but it's working in a way just on the skin itself. So it's at the surface. So it's not going to penetrate deep into the cells. It's not going to penetrate into the basement membrane where the cells are sitting, that scaffolding, and replace the hyaluronic acid that you've lost. It's not possible, it's too big a molecule to do that. I haven't come across any formulations that can credibly say this hyaluronic acid, you put it as a cream and then your cells will take it up and then it'll replace the hyaluronic acid that you have lost in your skin. That doesn't happen. The way that hyaluronic acid is replaced in your skin is your body makes it. And I can do another video about whether supplements can help. We have a video about collagen and how that may or may not help with skin regeneration. I'll leave a link to that. But I'll do the same with hyaluronic acid and see if there's a way to kind of, you know, answer your questions about whether we can regenerate the hyaluronic acid in our skin or boost the levels of it through our diets. That hyaluronic acid on the surface of your skin, it's going to have a lovely effect, but it's all superficial and it's all temporary. So if you don't use the hyaluronic acid, your skin is just going to be what it was, you know. If it was dry, it'll stay dry. So the hyaluronic acid effect is great, but it's short-lived, it's dependent on you using the product, and it's not going to have any impact on the cells themselves. If you are looking to kind of improve, if a treatment that will improve and increase, stimulate kind of the cells kind of from the inside out, then you are probably looking at something like Profilo injectable moisturizer. This has a high concentration of hyaluronic acid and it's injected superficially into the skin. And what it does is it works in twofolds. Number one, the hyaluronic acid will increase the hydration to the cells, and that it's a really nice kind of effect that that has. And we talked about having that juicy kind of radiant skin. But the other thing that it will do is it will stimulate the cells to make more collagen, more elastin, and that will kind of improve that basement membrane, the scaffolding that the cells hang out in. And so it'll help smooth out fine lines and wrinkles by plumping up the skin, by making the skin firmer. It will also make the skin a little bit thicker, that'll make it a little bouncier. And those changes are from the inside out. You have the injection and your skin will itself be stimulated to improve itself. So that's the difference between using hyaluronic acid as an injectable moisturizer, so such as Profilo. And Profilo, you would have usually two treatments, and they're usually about 4 to 6 weeks apart. And then you would repeat every 6 to 8 months. Some people need 3 treatments, 4 to 6 weeks apart, and that's if you have particularly kind of crepey, very wrinkly skin, it may need a bit more. But it's a great treatment, and like I said, it just works kind of from, you know, at the cellular level. But that's not to kind of dismiss what hyaluronic acid applied to the skin can do. It does amazing things, but it's just important to distinguish what level things are working. And then that also then brings me to hyaluronic acid dermal fillers. And these have hyaluronic acid, and it's usually it's a gel formation. And these fillers are designed to kind of fill. So if you have lost volume in your cheeks, for example, because of aging and the fat has reduced, then hyaluronic acid fillers in the midface will help kind of replace that lost volume. We know also fillers can be used, you know, to enhance the lips, sharpen up the jawline, define the contours of your face, fill in hollows. We can also use them to fill in deep folds and lines like the nose to mouth lines. So many different things. And the reason we can do that is at that point we're injecting the hyaluronic acid at the level of that kind of scaffold so that we can increase that sort of layer, so that we can enhance the volume, we can support the cells better. So with hyaluronic acid, you're injecting it at different depths depending on what you want to do. So if we're injecting around here or in the cheeks or the jawline, we're doing a much deeper injection than if we were using it for the lips, using it for these areas here. So it's just a different type of treatment. And in that situation, we're using hyaluronic acid not to moisturize or hydrate, and really not even to do anything to the skin. We're using it to support the skin and the underlying fat tissues so that the face can have a better structure, and we replace lost volume. So these are really important distinctions to make. And the effects of hyaluronic acid dermal fillers are temporary. So when the fillers wear out, it could be anything between 6 to 48 months, depending on the type of filler and where it's injected. But when they kind of dissolve, they're broken up down by your body over time, and then you're just left with what you have. So whatever your skin would be without fillers, this is how it will look. So these distinctions are important because I sometimes find in the marketing of skincare, they try and pretend or they try and suggest, I'm not gonna say pretend, they try and suggest that if you put hyaluronic acid on your skin, it's going to also, make your lips bigger, or it's going to change the structure of your face, or it's going to have a long-lasting effect. It's not going to do that. In the same way that things like Profilo, which does stimulate the cells to improve your skin from the inside out, or dermal fillers, which will actually provide that replacement of volume that we need to contour and smooth the face. These do separate things, but none of them are permanent. And that's not a bad thing, but it's just important that we're quite honest about this. And that way, you know, if you want to try a hyaluronic acid serum, you have realistic expectations of what it's going to do.